Happy New Year, guys, and Happy New Home Assistant 2024.1 release! Here are the most important things that have been delivered. The automation editor got a facelift. It's easier to use now thanks to a lot of little changes. Earlier, when you went to the automations page on Home Assistant, it was empty, which wasn't great if you were new. But now, there is a friendly robot explaining what automations do and offering links to learn more. When you're starting a new automation, you will find cleaner explanations and terms to help you understand each part better. And there are temporary images that disappear once you add things. The big difference is in the buttons for adding triggers, conditions, or actions to your automation. There is a new button besides conditions and action named Add Building Block. This helps add logical elements like AND, OR, IF, and choose. Before, these were mixed up, but now they have their own button, making it easier to spot and keeping things organized. Earlier, there used to be a drop-down for all these buttons. Now there is a new box with descriptions and a search tool. These descriptions explain what each trigger, condition, or action does. When you add something, the most commonly used one appeared first, while others are neatly organized. Finally, service calls are now included with all other actions. So, when you add an action, you will see them grouped by what they control and where they come from. They also come with descriptions and can be searched easily. I'll be talking about Home Assistant a lot, and if you didn't join the fun yet, now is a great time to start your Home Assistant journey. If you need a little help getting started, join my totally free webinar where I'll share the official ways to get Home Assistant, some pros and cons, and one super simple way to get started on a PC in under 5 minutes. Link and QR code to the webinar registration can be found on your screen. In Home Assistant 2024.1, you're able to put due dates and descriptions on every task in your to-do lists, right from the user interface. These things were only possible before by using Home Assistant services, but not anymore. Adding due dates and descriptions from UI are enabled if the integration allows it or if you're using a local to-do list. Do you have any smart valves that control your radiators, pools, irrigation systems, or just some water pipes? If yes, you can now add them in Home Assistant 2024.1 and they will have their own valve entity. At the moment, this could happen only if you have these valves in your MQTT broker or if you have some Shelly gas devices, but this is just the beginning and I'm pretty sure a lot will follow soon. Also, valves entity can be exposed to Alexa and Google Assistant, which is pretty nice. Starting from Home Assistant 2024.1, the thermostat and humidifier cards now allow you to set the current temperature or humidity as the main information displayed on these cards. When you activate this choice, the target temperature or humidity will switch places with the current readings. Simple as that, but good to have option, and it seems that it was requested a lot. Makes sense, doesn't it? Climate fan mode feature is also added in Home Assistant 2024.1. This feature can be used with both thermostat and climate cards. Also, you can now add update buttons right in the tile cards, and guess what will happen if you press on these buttons? Home Assistant will try to update your device's firmware or integration. Simple as that. As always, there are some other noteworthy changes in this update. Here are some of them. Cloud speech to text engine was moved to config entry. Good. Shelly Gen 3 devices support was added. I didn't even know that there was Shelly Gen 3 devices. Great. Consider home interval to pink. Presets modes to ESP home fan entities. And pretty much that's it. We have some new integrations as well in this latest Home Assistant release. Here are the most noticeable ones. A.O. Smith integration was out. I don't know these water heaters. Okay, Holiday, that's pretty good one. This integration allows you to create a calendar of holidays in Home Assistant. That's a great one. I can't wait to try it. Tailwind, garage door openers, TESI. Monitor and control your Tesla vehicle connected to the TESI platform. I don't know what is this TESI platform. Maybe if you have Tesla, you know that. Some new virtual integration are also added. Virtual integration are steps that are handled by other integrations, and these are the integrations that are supporting these new step integrations or virtual integrations. You can check them in the release notes. There are new integrations that can now be set up right from the UI, and these are Netgear LTE, Streamlabs, Suse Water, Swiss Public Transport, System Monitor. That's a good one. You can add it by clicking on this integration or from your Home Assistant user interface. Great one indeed. And Trend. This platform allows you to create sensor which will show the trend of numeric state or state attributes. Don't forget to check the backward incompatible changes, formerly known as braking changes. If you have some automations or creeps based on shutdown of Home Assistant event, you should definitely check this. If you're using Modbus configuration, there are some updates here as well. Reolink cameras, infrared lights has been migrated from light to switch domain. That's not a big of a change. And Shelly. If you have Shelly devices that are not recently updated, you should update them if they are below this firmware version. These are for the Shelly Gen 1 devices. This is the minimum version that you should have, and this is the minimum version if you have Shelly Gen 2 devices. If you have lower than these firmwares, you should update if you wish your devices, your Shelly devices, to work with Home Assistant. Get my smart home glossary if something is not quite clear for you. And this glossary is totally free and it comes as one big PDF file. Thanks for watching, I'm Kirill, and until next one, bye!